In the previous video, we already have seen the concept of multithreading. In this video, we will implement the multithreading in Java. Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the session 20 of Java and Vim, multithreading in Java. To implement multithreading in Java, we need two things. The first one is the interface whose name is runnable. The name of the interface is runnable. And second one is a class whose name is thread. The class thread implements the interface runnable. If you are working on Java 8 or lower versions of Java, then you can find the class thread or the interface runnable in the package java.lang. And the package java.lang is present in a jar file whose name is rt.jar. So inside the rt.jar, you will have a package whose name is java.lang. Inside the java.lang, you will find the class thread and the interface runnable. But if you are working on Java 9 and higher versions of Java, there you can find java.basemodule. In java.basemodule, you will have a package whose name is java.lang. In the package java.lang, you can find a class whose name is thread and you can find an interface whose name is runnable. So again, the class thread and the interface runnable is present in the package java.lang and the package java.lang is present in the module java.base. The class thread implements the interface runnable. So we are going to use this class or this interface to create a multi-threaded program in Java. To implement multi-threading in Java, we are going to create a class whose name is MyThread. There are two ways to implement the class MyThread. One way is by extending the class thread of java.lang package, and other way is by implementing the class runnable of java.lang package. The class MyThread extends the class thread, and the class thread implements the class runnable. The interface runnable has run method, and that run method implemented by the class thread. And the class thread has a start method. The MyThread overwrites the run method of the class thread. The class thread implements the run method of the class runnable, and the class MyThread overwrites the run method of the class thread and then calls the start method of the class thread to start a new thread. We will use these methods in a while. And if you are implementing multi-threading by using the interface runnable, then in the class MyThread, you will first implement the run method of the interface runnable, and then you will call the start method of the class thread. We will practically see these two methods to implement multi-threading in Java. To implement multi-threading, we need to create a class, say MyThread. Override the run method in the class MyThread. Whatever the code is inside the overridden method run executes in a separate thread other than the thread main. So whatever you write in the run method of the class MyThread, that code will be executed in a separate thread, a thread other than the main thread. After implementing the run method, we need to start the thread by using the start method. The newly created thread will execute in the parallel with the thread main. Now let's implement the multi-threading in Java by using the thread class. Here in this code, we are using two Java files, mythread.java and createthread.java. mythread.java has a class named MyThread, which extends the class thread. That's how the method run and the method start of the class thread got inherited from the class thread to the method MyThread. And after inheriting the method run from the class thread, the class MyThread is overriding that method. In the class MyThread, we have overridden the method run and we have put in a statement system.out.println 10 divided by 0, which will cause an arithmetic exception. The method run will execute in a separate thread than the thread main. We have another Java file, createthread.java, which contains the class createThread. In the class createThread, we have the method main. This method will execute in the thread main. Look at the difference. The method main executes in the thread main. Method main is different than the thread main. Thread main is the processing sequence in which the method main executes. And the method run will execute in a different thread, a thread different from the thread main. So we have two threads now. One is the thread main in which the method main will execute, and other one is the different thread in which the method run will execute. So now our Java program will have two threads. In the method main, which will execute in the thread main, we are creating a new object of type MyThread. So we are creating a reference variable T of type MyThread, which will contain a reference of the object of type MyThread. Then we are calling T.start. The start method, which got inherited in the class MyThread from the class thread, we are calling that start method by using reference variable of type MyThread. When you call this start method, it will start a new thread in the parallel of thread main, and in that thread, the method run will execute. That means you can say the method run is the entry point of the new thread. We know that the method main is an entry point to the main thread. In the same way, the method run is the entry point to the new thread. So after this statement, after calling the start method of the class MyThread, these two threads will execute in parallel. Therefore, when you compile these two Java files, mythread.java and createthread.java, you will get two class files as output. And when you execute the class createThread, an exception will occur in the new thread, arithmetic exception divided by 0. The name of the new thread is thread 0. As older thread name, the thread in which the method main is executing, the name of that thread is the thread main. But the name of the new thread is thread 0. If you create another thread by programming, then the name of that thread will be thread 1. If you create a third thread in your program, the name of the new thread will be thread 2, and so on. So unlike arithmetic exception in the previous video, which was happened in the thread main, at this time, the arithmetic exception is happening in the thread 0. So instead of writing here main, the JVM throws an exception in thread 0, java.lang.arithmeticException division by 0. Let's execute this code practically and see if JVM really throws this error or not. Open the file mythread.java, and this is the same code as we have seen. Now open the file createthread.java, and this is the same file as we have seen. Try to compile these two codes, Java C, mythread.java and createthread.java. Compiles fine. Now run it, Java createthread.java. We need to create that class file which contains the method main. The method main always executes in the thread main, and the method run always executes in the new thread. Press enter. You can see here exception in thread main, thread 0, java.lang.arithmeticException. So I hope you got the point that how to create new threads in Java. In the next video, we will see internal implementation of multi-threading in Java. That's all for this video, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe my channel on YouTube, like my page on Facebook, and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.